Hey, what's the deal, y'all? It's your boy Big Star, man. Too raw for the streets, man. Just want to thank y'all so much for joining me here on this. I mean, I don't know any other way to describe it, but I just call it a journey here on this part two of the Too Raw for the Streets journey, man. Short and sweet. I just want to thank everyone who was a part of that journey that started back in 1998, man. And I just want to tell you guys right now, it's really emotional for me to even be in front of this camera. You know, I haven't seen some of you guys since like the mid to late, you know, 2000s, around, you know, 06, 07, or, you know, whenever the time was that I retired and kind of, you know, stepped away. So I just want to, you know, use this time also as a time to say I apologize for just kind of disappearing like I did. But as you guys will find out, you know, throughout the journey of this YouTube channel, that, you know, I was not good with goodbyes. So that's the only way that I knew how to kind of just kind of step away and just kind of gracefully just kind of, you know, ride off into the sunset, man. It was a lot going on in my personal life regarding, you know, getting married, you know, raising a family. I have four boys now, my relationship with God growing. So my life was kind of just headed in a different direction. And that, you know, it was just time for me at that time to close that chapter of my life. Fast forward to now, it was a major thing that was kind of not eating me on the inside, but, you know, it was just something that I felt was right at the time to start the Too Raw for the Streets Instagram page. You know, tons of people were always reaching out to me like, yo, you know, what's up with the old stuff? Or, you know, thank you so much for your contribution, this and that. So with the support, and I guess with the help of social media, you know, I finally started, you know, I decided to create the Instagram page just to kind of, you know, pay homage to the legacy, get some of those memories out there, reconnect, you know, with some of the old brotherhood and everything. And just an opportunity to kind of get some of those clips out. And the response was crazy. So if you haven't already, make sure you are following the Too Raw for the Streets with the number two Instagram page. That's where, you know, that's a page that I created to just kind of, you know, dedicate, that I dedicated to the movement, for people and the fans, supporters, and the MCs who featured, to actually kind of all come and congregate, man, and to relive those memories. And so here we are now. Something else that God had laid on my heart, and, you know, was, hey, it's time to just, you know, start putting some of the stuff back out there again. So I created this YouTube channel to further, you know, pay homage to the movement. And it's a lot of things that I'm planning on doing, you know, in God's time. But on the surface, you know, straight from the beginning, man, the whole purpose for this YouTube channel that you're watching right now is to, you know, definitely pay homage to the legacy of Too Raw for the Streets. You know, continue to tell the story of the journey and everyone that was involved. One of my big goals is to get all of the raw footage out there, because people don't understand, I have millions of hours of footage that I filmed throughout that duration from 98 until I'd say like around, you know, 07, 08 when I retired and kind of walked away. But so much footage, like, the, for example, if I filmed one, okay, like the Cheek Raw classic with the wife beater freestyle in the alleyway, people don't understand that that's the one clip that made the DVD on Ground Zero that day, but that was a whole session, you know what I'm saying, with tons of other rhymes from Cheek Raw and Vodka and all that kind of stuff. So I'm getting all the raw footage out there, just emptying the vault of all the raw footage. And then also, it's tons of MCs who never even made the cut. Not that, you know, they weren't hot enough or nothing like that, but it just wasn't enough time on a 2-hour DVD or VHS or whatever to fit everybody. So, you know, individuals that didn't make the cut on, say, Ground Zero or Starlito's Way or something like that, I would have a mental note to get them on the next one. Well, come time for the next one, I had done filmed, you know, for a whole another, you know, couple months and had a whole bunch of new stuff, so I would forget about old stuff. So it's tons of stuff that got left behind. Tons of MCs, tons of really dope MCs that I filmed that I never got a chance to feature. So I'll be, you know, dumping all that stuff on there. All kinds of stuff, man. So I just want to thank you guys again for this journey, man. Make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel, man. My goal and my blessing, you know, my goal And you know, with God's will, man, is that this Too Raw for the Streets YouTube channel, man, it just grows and grows, man, and everyone, people from across the world, this is where they'll come to just, you know, relive those Too Raw for the Streets memories, man. You know, I'm still Too Raw for the Streets, man, big star, man. So I just want to thank everyone, man, for all that you guys have done for me over the years. Thank you guys for helping to grow the platform. You know, this was before YouTube, before social media. You know, it was one man, one camera, you know, with a vision, just to support people, just to help out the community, just to see everybody win, man. So I couldn't even begin to shout out, you know, all my alumni, man, so I'm not even going to do it. You know, you guys know who you are. Those ones where when the camera shut off, you know, where it was deeper than it wasn't about the camera, you know, my brothers, man. So again, want to thank the MCs, want to thank all the supporters, fans, the DJs, the street vendors, you know what I mean, the stores, you know, my homie Big Chris, my bro, everyone that was a part of the Too Raw for the Streets movement, man. This YouTube channel is dedicated to you. Again, make sure you follow the Too Raw for the Streets Instagram page, and make sure you're subscribing to this YouTube channel. Daily content, weekly content I'll be uploading, and make sure you guys spread the word, because you know, the movement is pretty much here, man. And this would serve as a museum of the Philadelphia area hip-hop history, through the eyes of Big Star and Too Raw for the Streets. Thank you.
They got me feeling like the greatest. No competition, boy, I'm number one. Ain't nobody messing with me, boy, I'm number one. This history in the making, dog, I'm number one. The game is mine, yeah, I'm number one.
Started in last place, now I got him, I'm number one. Started in last place, now I got him, I'm number one. Started in last place, now I got him, I'm number one.
Dog, I feel like the greatest, no competition, I'm number one. 24 hours around the clock like I'm Kobe. I be putting that work in it.